with you, but I'm going to start focusing, I think, a little more on actual numbers and facts and see if I can draw a better conclusion in the future as to who's making the most of the insane, nutty, you know, fringy noise.
I think that it wouldn't be too far out of the realm for someone on the left to make the threats themselves to make the right appear crazy.
Yeah, listen, I was just going with anecdotally is the best word to use here, that as I've sat in this chair and I've done this show since October of 2001, yet the lunacy appears to be significantly more on the left as far as the number of stories and items and what I processed. Again, that's from a quick recollection and an anecdotal assessment, but I'm going to start paying more attention to, you know, maybe some empirical numbers going forward. David, that's a thank you, because that's given me something to do here, and I always like to learn. Every day I want to learn something, and folks, as a human, you should be the same way. When you stop learning, well, just shut the lights out, bottom line. David, thanks for the call, and enjoy the beauty of Alaska. Let's hit Florida. Mike is in Port Charlotte. Hello, Mike, you're on Schmidt. Welcome.
Hey, how you doing? I listen to every day.
Thank you.
Leery about this whole routine myself. I don't think that they're getting as many death threats as they're saying. I think this is a lot of political ploy to make the right look like really bad people. I mean, right people are in a certain way. They say there's nuts on both sides.
Right.
But,
just something that comes to mind quickly as far as, you know, fringes and some of the wackiness that occurs. Couple of years that there were incidents, whether there were arsons or there were